Alright, hi everybody. This is Don Derwin over in New Zealand. 737-900. And I'm over at Queenstown. And I've put a flight plan in here to Christchurch. But it's not exactly the way this is. You go around in circles a little here. But this is just to get my airplane into. But this is right here. Just to get my airplane in a spot there. Come in into ILS, Christchurch there. So that'd be a pretty neat little flight. Then here's it in sim brief. It's all the current winds. Actually, it's not really the right time of day because right now it's 5 in the morning. Here I'm in Rhinelander, Wisconsin, but I don't want to fly at night there. But I've been meaning to do this for a little while. I have this at flight 320, except I'm only going up to 280. Because, actually, the FMC said it couldn't do it. So I can kind of see why. And it's in 4K too, so it'll look pretty nice. I just shut that off. The sound there. So here's the runway there. And then the departure. This departure looks pretty cool. That one. So you take off here, and I put all the altitudes in here, 6,000. It's going to be around 9,000 there. And it does a little circle and goes this way to there. And to Tim Jewell. And I put all the altitudes in there. And going to it's Dopey runway 20. Coming in like this. The one thing when I did it from SimBrief, it kind of screwed me up here, because it wanted to go here, but I put it going to out here. I think it's Odessa. I would rather, you know, go out there a little ways. Then approach is runway 20. See, I have it coming out to here. The chart's got it coming to here, but so I had to get rid of this. I tried to erase it, but it wouldn't erase. So I just covered up with Odessa, you know, this, because it really screwed it up there. But just if you're trying to program it in. Right, 20 there. And there's runway 20 there. Yeah, this was my computer before. 32-inch monitor there. Now I got a 4K 43-inch. So it's pretty nice. But I suppose it's not really the best monitor, but I think it'll work. But it's the, my monitors, it's the Acer CG437K. CG437K. Well, they say the action's not so good when you turn, you know, like when you turn around like this, but I don't really, maybe a little, but I mean, not really. I can't really tell at all, but maybe sometimes I can kind of notice, but when you look at it from the side, it's a little bit lighter, but I guess every monitor's got its drawbacks. I mean, I like an OLED, it burns it in. I would never want one of those. But they say they look really good. So, alright. So I got some programmed in here. So I'll just go through this. So if you wanted to put this in yourself, I'll just go through the pages. So you can see how it goes. Thank you. Yeah, this is where it was screwing me up here. Instead of going out here, it was going from here to there. I don't know, some people, I don't know, even me, sometimes if I didn't do it for a while. One time I was forgetting how to do the plan, how to step through it, you know. Of course it changes here. But just put it over here to plan. When I was trying to look at the I found out that PMDG's got some screws in the wrong spot. These screws are supposed to be here. I was looking at some of the stuff under here in the midair like this. They're not supposed to be there. It's kind of... Oh, here they are here. They're just floating. It's just when it closes up, it goes up there. I'm like, wow. It's kind of screwed up. But, I was looking in the main landing gear wheel well, looking at some of the stuff in there. So I got the Boeing 737 technical guide by Chris Brady, and I was going through it, and it doesn't really look like it's supposed to. I mean, some of it does, but some of it don't. But I put the airplane upside down, and I crashed it, and then try to get the light to shine in there at different times of day. Cause yeah, it's really dark in there. But I got some of these pictures. Yeah, but I mean, this is very detailed though. It's a hydraulic, I guess that's B reservoir. And here's the there. Here is supposed to be the APU fire handle. It's supposed to be up, but really doesn't quite look like it in the book. And this doesn't quite look the same either. There's a little bit more here, but you know what? I wonder what these things are. I've always wondered what those are. Sure, they have something to do with vortices, maybe trying to keep it straight. I don't know. I don't know, I just thought I'd show you that really quick. But anyway, it's kind of interesting stuff there. So I guess I'm going to be ready to go. Everything's set. And I don't want to spend too much time because I got to go to sleep. All right. Well, I say you're supposed to wait like 2 minutes before you put the air on. I got there's the oh, maybe I could listen to the Diatus.
Queenstown Ground, New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie with Charlie ready to taxi IFR.
New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie taxi to and halt short of runway 05 via taxiway Alpha Tree. Contact tower on 118.1 when ready.
Taxi to and hold short runway 05 via taxiway Alpha Tree, New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie.
Queenstown Airport information, Charlie 0600 Zulu. Wind 053 at 4. Visibility, 3. Sky condition, few clouds at 2,600 feet, few clouds at 4,800 feet. Temperature, 8. Dew point, 10. Altimeter tree 0.08. Visual runway 05 in use. Landing and departing runway 05. ZFR aircraft say direction of flight. All aircraft read back hold short instructions. Advise controller on initial contact, you have Charlie. Queenstown Airport information, Delta 0600 Zulu.
Yeah, one time I was actually flying in a real airplane. I just didn't bother listening to ATIS. I'm like, ah, looks good. I was at night, went flying. But the ceiling was like, and I was only VFR. The ceiling was like 2,800 or something like that, overcast. And I started to go up in it, and I'm like, oh, it started to get dark. I'm like, oh, crap. Came down a little bit. I'm like, oh, from then on, you know what? Always listen to the ATIS. Yeah, it's a good habit. Yeah, I listened to the ATIS, and yep, sure enough, that's where the ceiling was. That's going to look nice in 4K there. And my frame rates are actually really good. That 4090 graphics card thing's great.
Queenstown Ground, New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie requesting pushback.
New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie pushback request accepted.
Queenstown Ground, New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie requesting the end of pushback.
New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie request to end pushback received.
Queenstown Ground, New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie requesting pushback.
New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie pushback request accepted.
Yeah, I wanted to get a different pushback. I thought that other one was work, the Ambitious Pilots one, but it don't work. Because of an update.
Queenstown Ground, New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie requesting pushback tug to steer the aircraft to the right.
New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie, your request has been transmitted to the operator.
Queenstown Ground, New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie requesting pushback tug to push the aircraft straight.
New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie, your request has been transmitted to the operator.
Queenstown Ground, New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie requesting the end of pushback.
New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie request to end pushback received.
And until I found out what I was doing wrong with these brakes, I got to put on my toes all the way forward. I mean, I was trying to do it, but I really wasn't sticking my toes all the way forward. The crosswind rudder pedals, I love those things. Cost a lot of money, but I really like them. Well worth it. time I got my altitude in there and my landing elevation. Yeah, this time I don't have to press this, and I just use my toes. Yeah, I was really upset about that thing, but now I find out that it works really well. I guess I will try the Toby Track IR there. Turn it on. I suppose it helps. Yeah, I guess the thing with the Toby IR is you just gotta shut it off when you don't need it. When you're going down the runway, well, I guess the flight controls didn't do that, did I? I was thinking of one thing, now I forgot what I was doing. So, here's the lift, okay, before takeoff, flaps, green light, stabilizer trim units, yep, I put that in there, 3.6. Oh, and then this thing goes down too. So command LNAV, VNAV. So flight director, there's my V speeds. Right, and I think I'm gonna hold my brakes. Right, I'm ready to go. Can't believe I forgot the gear. That I think I did forget. The one time I did it, I have the two buttons right next to each other for the Tobii IR to go off. Accidentally hit it the first time, but I think I did forget it this time. It's the ATIS.
0600 Zulu. Wind calm. Visibility 6. Sky condition, few clouds at 3,300 feet, ceiling 4,800 feet overcast. Temperature 10.
Tower 118.4.
2500.
Thank you.
Well, at the end there, I thought the, the airplane was taking care of the throttle, but, I guess not. Alright. Barometric pressure, that's right. I just pressed the B key. So,
Christchurch Ground, New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie, could you please connect the jetway to the aircraft?
New Zealand 8 Victor Charlie, the jetway is going to be connected.
All right. So all right, my my second flight of PMD G737-900. Yeah, I forgot the landing gear and take off. But I don't know. Hey, I don't know. That's something I always do anyway. But I don't know why I forgot that. But anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you liked the video. Okay, catch y'all later. And don't forget to like and subscribe too. Catch y'all later. Okay, bye.